Right now, we're facing a man-made disaster of global scale. Our greatest threat in thousands of years. Climate change. If we don't take action, the collapse of our civilizations and the extinction of much of the natural world is on the horizon. The world's people have spoken. Their message is clear. Time is running out.
Hello, my name is Nadia Vina Hetharia. I'm an international relations student from the London School of Public Relations, Jakarta. And I'm from class IR22-2SP, and my lecturer is Charles Bonar Sirait. And this time I will explain about the climate change. This is a simple explanation of climate change based on an article in the New York Times. The average temperature on the surface of the planet has already increased 1.7 degrees Fahrenheit since 1880, which may not seem like much, but think about it this way. The heat from human emission is roughly equal to 400,000 Hiroshima atomic bombs exploding across the planet every single day. Future generations are in big trouble, but for now, it will continue to get warmer and storm will grow more intense with longer periods of drought in between. But longer term, if emissions continue to rise unchecked, the climate disaster will be served. They will destabilize entire nation, send millions of refugees across border, cause widespread extinction of most species on Earth, and melt the polar ice caps, leaving most of the world coastal cities several feet underwater. All this could take centuries, but something like the sudden collapse of agriculture will trigger immediate chaos in society. Best case is we get out at together and begin to rapidly bring emission levels down. Meanwhile, Earth turns put to be less sensitive to greenhouse gases than we currently believe. Plants and animals adapt quickly, and major technological breakthrough helps society limit emissions, adjust to climate change. But these are all the opposite of what we're actually seeing. So the only thing in our control is to limit emissions using all available tools and best behavior currently at our disposal. Worst case, the collapse of food production causes spiraling price, and as our capitalist utopia breaks down, billions starve as our work gets violent and messy real quick. It's kind of like a zombie apocalypse, but with extreme hunger spreading chaos instead. So yeah, still just lying as a zombie apocalypse. This would be coupled with the melting of the Antarctic ice sheet, leading to rapidly rising seas that would force us to abandon many of our greatest cities and all of the social and scientific progress that we're making within them. Adding insult to injury is the fact that many of the emissions were emitted while building these now abandoned underwater metropolises. If emissions continue unchecked, we're looking at a total rise of between 80 to 160 feet, which would occur if all the ice in the poles melted. So the ocean will rise. The real question is how fast? Scientists only have Earth history to base their prediction, on which you guess that the rate has occasionally hit 1 foot per decade. So we'll have to adapt to an altered coastal bill sooner or later, but probably much sooner than later. Because computer forecasts oddly give us a range of future possibilities, the most important evidence comes from the study of past climate condition, which clearly that every time the amount of carbon dioxide in the Earth rises, the Earth warms up, ice melts, and the ocean rises. What's important to remember here is that we are uncharted territory. Humans are and carbon dioxide into the air far faster than nature ever has before us. Scientists have been publishing strong evidence that warming is making drought and heat waves more frequent, causing heavier rainstorm and more surf coastal folding. But while the internet has made us all aware of weather disaster in distant country, it's hard to prove these are directly made worse by climate change. Canada and Russia both have vast frozen land and could see more economic benefit from a warmer climate. Putin and Russian therefore have been reluctant to make ambitious climate commitments, but expect that to change as these countries realize they will have swamped by millions of refugees from less fortunate nations. Libertarians and other political conservatives do not like the policies proposed to fight climate change and have chosen to try and block them by actively undermining the science. This effort has been funded by the oil and coal industry, who favor making money above all else. As more resources are devoted to avoiding the problem, our chances at big technological breakthrough are improving, but we still should be spending about three times as much money as we currently are on this effort, according to several in-depth reports. You can reduce your carbon footprint by doing things like plugging leaks in your home insulation, installing a smart thermostat, taking a public transit, taking less airplane trips, buying an electric car, and putting solar panels on your roof. A big one is eating less meat. But what's really needed is for you to speak up and exercise your right as a citizen, because strong collective action through the state and national policies is how we'll make the most impact. Considering that we've been ignoring scientists' warnings since the 80s to limit emissions, we're pretty late in the game. But we've finally reached a moment where nearly every country in the world agrees this is a huge problem and seem ready to commit to taking at least some kind of action. Leading corporations will continue to make bold promises to do their part. Low emission technologies will improve, and many states and cities will go much further than any goals set by their national government. The United States, the world's biggest economy, is finally starting to move aggressively, and China, the world's largest emitter, is beginning to recognize that it needs to do the same, as many of its megacities will be underwater if the seas rise too high. But it's up to you, the ordinary citizen, to continue demanding our political leaders tackle climate change, the harder problem that humanity has ever faced. So, we must take an action from now to save our Earth before it's too late. I'm Nadia, and thank you for watching.